The Denver Broncos are stuck between a Brock and a hard place. With Paxton Lynch still not healed enough to play quarterback, it looks like the Broncos will go with Brock Osweiler again this week on Sunday Night Football against the New England Patriots in NFL Week 10. Hall of Famer Tom Brady will be coming off of the bye week and will start for the Patriots, so things could get very ugly in the Mile High City, where the Patriots are favored by 7.5 points. The New England Patriots hit the break at 6-2 straight up and 4-4 against the number. It has not been pretty for the majority of the season, but New England has covered 3 of its last 4 games, with each of the last 4 games going under the total. When the Patriots got off to a bit of a rough start, everybody knew why. The offense has never been the problem. Once again, the Patriots are in the midst of averaging 6 yards per play, and only Kansas City has turned the ball over fewer times than the Patriots. New England is still having some trouble running the football effectively, with just 3.9 yards per carry. But offensive balance is overrated when TB12 is the quarterback. The Patriots rank 5th in completion percentage, 1st in yards, 5th in yards per catch, and 3rd in adjusted net yards per pass attempt. The bye week did come at a good time for the Patriots, who have moved the football effectively, but have been held to 24 points or less in 4 straight weeks. Tom Brady has completed exactly 2/3 of his passes with a 16-2 touchdown interception ratio. With Chris Hogan hurt and Julian Edelman out since the start of the year with a torn ACL, Brandon Cooks has been a fine addition with 33 grabs for a team-leading total of 563 yards. Rob Gronkowski remains reliable with 34 grabs and 509 yards. The Patriots continue to use passes to Deion Lewis, James White, and Rex Burkhard as extensions of the run, and that trio has 65 catches on the season. While New England's defense has done better in the points department, the Patriots are still giving up too many yards. The Patriots are last in the NFL in yards per play allowed by a full half yard at 6.6. New England's run defense is the only one in the NFL that has allowed more than 5 yards per carry this season and only has 9 takeaways. But despite all the yardage, opponents have only scored on 34.5% of their possession, which ranks right in the middle of the pack. Only 3 teams have allowed more yards per catch than New England. The Denver Broncos have dropped 4 straight games straight up and against the spread. Denver is poised to miss the playoffs in consecutive seasons for the first time since 2009. Overall, Denver is 3-5 straight up and 2-5-1 against the spread. 226 yards. That's what the Broncos managed on Sunday against the Philadelphia Eagles. The Eagles had a great game plan and were able to get pressure with 4 against a quarterback that can't move and an offensive line that has some holes. Brock Osweiler will get another crack at it this week for whatever reason. He is 21 of 42 for 226 yards with a touchdown and 2 interceptions on the season. The Broncos have rushed for 4.2 yards per carry this season, but the fact that the Broncos have so much trouble moving the ball through the air has made it hard to score points. All the turnovers haven't helped either. Only the hapless and pathetic Cleveland Browns have turned the ball over more than the Broncos this season. 12 of those 19 turnovers are interceptions. This week, Denver should be able to keep the ball on the ground and move it with some measure of success. But the Patriots also have had extra time to fix their defensive problems. And speaking of defensive problems, Denver's back finally broke on that side of the ball in their last game. The Broncos gave up 51 points to the Eagles. Denver's yards per play allowed went from 4.5 to 4.7 in the span of just one game. As good as the base defense has played, the Broncos are not forcing enough turnovers to set the offense up for more success. The path of least resistance doesn't exist for the offense, and they just make things harder for the defense. The Broncos are minus 12 in turnover margin through 8 games, and that is going to make it hard on any team to have success. Denver's defense has held the opposition to 3.4 yards per carry and a 59.8% completion rate, but the lack of big plays to change momentum has been an Achilles heel. That probably won't change this week either with a guy like Tom Brady that takes care of the football so well. As much as the New England defense has struggled, the Broncos offense is just as bad and probably will not be able to take advantage this week. Denver's offense has managed just 4.9 yards per play on the year, and all of those turnovers have been a backbreaker. Denver's defense should rebound from last week's performance, but there's no telling what number they need to hold the Patriots to in order to cover the spread. The best way to bet this one is to see if you can get a 7 or tease New England down and the total up to 53 and play back on the under.